Oh, holy shit! Another video from Neon! What is he gonna do now, the crazy bastard? Well, let me tell you here right now. You remember that HP that I showed off in like the previous video? Well, it turns out that case smells like a fucking rat's asshole. Now, let me grab here something. Before I show it to you guys, do you remember what I told you about in one slight second of a fucking whatever? I told you about building a PC out of a box. And because I got that other motherboard in that HP fixed, if you want to know what the specs that we're going to use for the one guy who is actually interested, here you go. We're going to build a PC out of a cardboard box. Here we are with our cardboard box, all of our stuff. And what I'm also going to do is, this is entirely optional, you don't actually have to do it. I'm going to give it a little bit of a front I.O. so I don't actually always have to reach around in the back or start a motherboard with like a screwdriver or shorter pins or whatever. I actually got some front I.O. So here's like one of those USB cards, readers and all that. There's a USB front on the port. This thing as well, which is basically a button, which two LEDs, one drive LED and one power LED. But this button doesn't really always work, and also looks ugly as fuck. If I really press hard enough, maybe you hear a click. Oh, there it goes. But yeah, I don't like that, so here's this little other button. Gonna solder it on there. And basically fix the problem. Motherboard here, and cardboard here. Now, what I do recommend is, before you go ham on one of these, basically put all the components in. See what fits where, and then only put it down with some zip ties or duct tape or whatever the fuck you're gonna use. You can see everything fits in here. Now I know it looks like an absolute mess. None of the cables are connected and all that stuff. And you put your hard drive on top of the PCU, which is gonna probably overheat a little bit. And the cooler is put down with zip ties, also pretty ghetto, I guess. But I got a fix for at least a hard drive problem. The zip ties are gonna stay, obviously. I'm gonna cut these flaps off, probably, because they're not really evenly cut in my OCD, kind of OCD, I guess. Does not allow that to stand here, so these are gonna go away. One of these cardboards are gonna be in between the hard drive and the power supply, so at least they're a little bit separated. And yeah, that's pretty much the planning for it. First thing you should probably do is draw the I.O. off, and then cut it out. Once you have drawn it off, like here, like I said, then you have to cut it out. You have done that, and now you have that you can properly see in which where your motherboard is going to be placed. You grab yourself a pen, go in all these six holes, and draw them off like that. And see, there are little holes over there. Now what you want to do is grab one of these little things. And basically, this is the best way I've personally found out. Just go all the way through. Push a little hard until you're through the second layer, so at least it comes out on the other side. Now I've tried one here as well. Then you can see where you have to put your zip ties through. And see, there are little holes over there. Now what you want to do is grab one of these little things. And basically, this is the best way I've personally found out. Just go all the way through. Push a little hard until you're through the second layer. So at least it comes out on the other side. Now I've tried one here as well. Then you can see where you have to put your zip ties through. You have punched your holes, then you're gonna have to put zip ties through it. Now obviously you have to punch two holes because the zip tie has to hold on something, and you know it has to come in and out. Obviously I don't have to fucking explain this. Now the best way that some people drill a little hole or something, I just punched one, but it's obviously too small, so the way I fix it, just fucking ram one in there and then it sticks out. So that would work as well. Now I'm gonna put the motherboard off camera because I can't do it on camera, so with the magic of editing, look at that, yo. Zip ties are in, the middle one obviously not, because that's pointless. They're all sturdy, you can wiggle the box around, it's not gonna come out of there. That's Okay, also I've also done the edges off so that at least it's already done and I don't have to be like, oh, I have to do the edges, oh. Well, let's get on the next step, putting the hard drive on top of the power supply. Now that we've put our motherboard in there, now we're gonna put the hard drive on top of the power supply with the help of these zip ties. Yeah, they don't want to show up on screen, but whatever, we'll roll with it. You probably could have noticed with the amount of times I've struggled. It was not as easy as I thought getting it on there, especially with a bit of a shortage issue and almost, I think, even hitting my camera once. But it's on there. I can lift the whole thing up. It's sturdy. I'm even gonna put some extra zip ties on there when I mount it in the box itself. But yeah, that's how you mount a hard drive on the power supply, I guess. Okay. Mounted the power supply. I'm not gonna do a detailed explanation how I did it because it's the same as the motherboard. You know, basically punch your holes, put in your zip ties, tie them, and be done with it. And technically, this box right here could be your PC. You could hook this up, all the stuff, and then you could short a wire here to make it run with like a knife or a fucking screwdriver, whatever you want. But, as you saw in the beginning of this video, we're gonna add some I.O. With this button and all that stuff. Probably gonna add a fan here as well. And that's pretty much it. I'm not gonna show how I did it, because basically, tomato tomato, and it would be boring to show you that. So I'm gonna show you the end result with the magic of editing. And after doing some black magic editing, we got here our full PC. Now, as you can see, hard drive here, IDE cable, obviously, that's not the nicest thing in the fucking PC. I'm still not happy how it looks, but that's an IDE cable for you. It's ugly. Added some buttons over here, and then the I.O. shield is here, so it's some USB, so I can at least plug in something in the front. I don't always have to reach for the back. And yeah, it's pretty fucking cool. If you guys want to see it run, let's do it right now. Oh, here we go. Also, probably everyone noticed, yeah, I know, a little bit too much solder, but whatever. I put Linux on there because it's not gonna be anything more than a simple, you know, just browsing thing. If someone comes by and wants to browse the internet or something, I'll give them this. I know it's not the nicest thing to give or something. Well, you know, I have sometimes a lot of friends over and they need a PC as well to play some online games with me, man. The only game that's probably gonna run on it, considering it's Linux and the specs, is probably... I'm gonna probably do some Half-Life games with that thing. And yeah, this is pretty sweet. Thank you for watching, by the way, and seeing how this box PC turned out. I did some gaffer tape here as well to clean it up. And yeah, I love how it actually turned out. It looks a lot nicer than I actually thought, although I probably would have wished to get some thicker cardboard, because as you can see, it's bending a little bit, but that's not too bad. Well, thank you for watching. I'll definitely post some more videos. I'll try to do it as soon as possible, because for the simple reason, these videos were filmed when I was having school, and now it's the vacation, so yay, more videos, I guess. And see you in the next one.